The United Nations Security Council is the most powerful organization in the entire world. And out of 5 permanent seats in this organ of the United Nations, Africa has none. Why? And what are the implications and what should we do about it? Let us find out now. The United Nations has 6 main organs. And the 6 main organs of the UN are the Secretariat, the General Assembly, Security Council, International Court of Justice, Trusteeship Council, and Economic and Social Council. Of all these 6 organs of the UN, the most important and the most powerful is the United Nations Security Council. The Security Council has the power to admit or to reject membership of prospective nations into the United Nations. It has power to place sanctions on member nations. It has power to reject any attempt to redraw the Charter of the United Nations. It has power to dispatch UN peacekeeping forces across the world. And any country that wants to make use of force across the world must get a permission from the United Nations Security Council. Since this council has the power to accept or to reject membership of any nation of the world and to redraw the map of the world when there's any dispute across the world, it shows that it has the power to decide the destinies of nations of the world. And no organization in the world has any power as such as the United Nations Security Council. And this Security Council is far more powerful than the General Assembly, which is the assembly of all the heads of states in the world. The General Assembly does not have any binding resolution on the entire world, but any resolution by the Security Council is binding on nations of the world. The Security Council meets often and on whenever there is the need, whereas the General Assembly meets only from about September to around January and a few other times. The Security Council is the most powerful organization in the world. And this Security Council has 5 permanent members out of 15 members of the Security Council. And these 5 permanent members are France, the US, UK, Russia, and China. And it has 10 non-permanent members whose seats are only for 2 years. Whereas the permanent members have been permanent members of the Security Council since the year 1945, when the United Nations Security Council began to sit. And these 5 permanent Security Council members have what we call veto power. They have the power to veto any resolution that can affect the entire world. This power of veto is found in Article 27, verse 3 of the United Nations Charter, which says that votes on non-procedural matters shall be by the affirmative votes of 9 out of the 15 members of the United Nations Security Council and by the concurring votes of all permanent members. This is where the veto power came in. With this veto power, France, the US, UK, Russia and China can say no to any resolution carried out in the United Nations Security Council, even if all the 14 other members say yes. This power is why the United Nations Security Council permanent membership is the most powerful membership any nation can have in the entire world. And unfortunately, no African nation is part of the United Nations permanent membership. And those nations who are permanent members of the United Nations Security Council, these are the real United Nations. They are the real world powers. In fact, being a permanent member of the United Nations Security Council is tantamount to being a world power and to being a real member of the United Nations. And unfortunately, no African nation is found in this class. And it is not without serious implications for us. And the implications are, the United Nations Security Council will keep working against the interests of Africans. Over 60% of the resolutions of the United Nations Security Council and over 70% of the peacekeeping that they have dispatched across the world all affect Africa. And it is unfortunate that African nations are not a party to affairs that affect them. And two, it shows that decolonizing in Africa will continue. Britain and France colonized at least 95% of Africa according to worldatlas.com. And Britain alone colonized about 30% of Africa, which shows that France colonized about 65% of all of Africa. And these two nations are permanent members of the United Nations Security Council and have veto powers. And with the veto powers, they can decide to continue the colonization of Africa, which they have always been doing. France has 14 African countries that it signed new colonial deals with, that there should be continuation of colonization even after independence. And part of the deals, the 11 deals that they signed, that they will continue using the CIFA, continue using French as a language, and that they will keep depositing at least 75 to 85% of their foreign treasury with France. And that these countries will be paying France billions of dollars of colonial taxes every single year. And that France has right to first refusal of the natural resources found in these countries. Britain controls over $1 trillion worth of natural resources in Africa, whereas these resources should belong to all Africans. This is despite the fact that the resolution 1514 of the United Nations General Assembly says that all the colonies in the world should have their independence. And this resolution was passed on the 14th of December 1960. Unfortunately, the resolutions of the United Nations General Assembly, as I said earlier, are not binding. It is the resolutions that are made by the National Security Council that are binding on nations and are mandatory. If not, after having that resolution 1514, why should we still have these countries oppressing African nations? So, with this, African nations will still remain subservient to European nations. Also, Africa cannot get justice through the United Nations. How will we get justice when France and Britain will always block any attempt by Africa to use the United Nations to get justice? Because any real action that will be carried out by the United Nations will not go through the General Assembly. It must go through the United Nations Security Council. And once any powerful nation of the five permanent member states know, that will be the end. And it shows that the United Nations Security Council can be used against Africa at any time. And France and Britain and these countries, they have used the Security Council against Africa several times. For example, on the 26th of February 2011, the Security Council passed a resolution, Resolution 1970, that declared that all Gaddafi's assets should be seized, and they referred Gaddafi to the International Criminal Court. Also, they passed the resolution 1973, 17th of March 2011, that declared a no-flying zone across Libya, whereas France went about bombing parts of Libya, including the Gaddafi man-made river project. And they also declared sanctions on Gaddafi's allies. And on 20th of October 2011, Gaddafi was summarily executed for committing no crime. The International Security Council has been used against Africa. And since there's no permanent member from Africa in this Security Council, it will keep being used against Africa. Also, the Security Council of the UN has the power to approve or to reject any person from being the Secretary General of the United Nations. And we know that we have had two African Secretary Generals of the United Nations by the name Boutros Ghali from Egypt and Kofi Annan from Ghana. Boutros ruled the United Nations as General Secretary from the year 1992 to the year 1996, while Kofi Annan was from 1997 to the year 2006. These two persons could not decolonize Africa, they could not do much for Africa. Why? The Security Council approves who becomes the Secretary General of the United Nations, and they can remove the person, or they can declare that the person will not get a second tenure if they don't like the person. And such has happened. For example, Boutros Ghali, when he was the Secretary General of the UN, he was using his power as a Secretary General to oppose some of his policies. And because of that, the Clinton administration was not happy with him. And when his first tenure ended in the year 1996, US used pocket veto to disallow him from going back to a second tenure in the year 1997. Instead, they preferred Kofi Annan, even though over 100 nations of the world chose Ghali Ghali and wanted him to continue to be the Secretary General of the United Nations. US did not allow him to continue. And they chose Kofi Annan, who they could detect to what they wanted him to do. And because of that, no one can use the Secretary Generalship to fight and get the rights of Africans in the United Nations. Even the current Secretary General of the United Nations, Guterres Antonio, has said that there needs to be a reform in the Security Council of the United Nations. Also, Africa cannot get reparations through the United Nations because they will block it through the Security Council. France and Britain will not allow that to happen. And Africa cannot also address the issue of neocolonialism through the United Nations because it is through the Security Council that the decisions will be made and these countries will reject. And also, ethnic groups in Africa that want to have states of their own to redraw the map of Africa from the way the colonizers drew it according to their own interests, which is still causing problems across Africa today, causing Africa to remain underdeveloped. The Security Council will block any nation that wants to be free in Africa. So they will maintain the map of Africa the way it is and be causing problems across Africa. Therefore, Africa is not yet free and Africa is not yet equal to European nations because The Security Council, which is the most powerful organization in the world, still belong to those who colonized Africa and those who still maintain new colonialism in Africa. And the only way to break free is by a reform. And first of all, we must even know, why is it that Africa is not a permanent member of the United Nations Security Council? Is Africa not a member of the United Nations? Let's go to the history. It is because of the history of the United Nations that Africa does not have the permanent seat. That is the major reason. The United Nations was formed within the years 1942 to the year 1945. And it was a follow-up of the League of Nations, which was formed in the year 1919 and began to seat in the year 1920. The nations that formed the United Nations are the nations that are the permanent members of the United Nations Security Council. For example, in the year 1944, the four victors of the Second World War, Britain, US, the UK, and China, came together and wrote the draft of the Charter of the United Nations and gave veto powers to themselves. That veto power can be found in Article 27, verse number 3 of the United Nations, as I mentioned earlier. And they're the ones that wrote and gave themselves that veto power. At the time of the formation of the United Nations, most African nations were not yet free. Egypt got her independence in 1922, but Suez Canal was still under the possession of the Britons. 1846, Liberia got her independence, but was not yet an influential nation in the world. And Ethiopia, that was never colonized, but was at some time occupied by the Italians, was not yet influential. So none of them could influence the formation of the United Nations, and they were not there when the draft of the United Nations or the Charter was drafted. So they could not put themselves in the United Nations Security Council permanent membership. Also, another reason is that there is still not yet an African superpower. The nations that are part of the United Nations Security permanent membership, they are all world powers, or they were at some point world powers. For example, France was instrumental to the formation of the League of Nations. France, US, and UK formed the League of Nations. Now, China is currently a world power. And as of then, China resisted the invasion from Japan from the year 1937 to the year 1945. So China withstanding a great power like Japan, showed that China as of then was a great power at least. And it was the US, through President Franklin Delano Roosevelt, that China was able to join the United Nations Security Council. If not, it would have been the US, UK, and the USSR alone. And France, it was the UK, Winston Churchill, that demanded that France should be part of the United Nations Security Council permanent membership as a form of bulwark against the Soviet Union or against the rise of Germany. So no African nation was powerful enough to come into this Security Council permanent membership, and no African nation had anybody to bring him or bring it into the Security Council permanent membership. So because of that, Africa did not have that permanent membership seat and still does not have it up to today. And an observation is that all the five nations of the United Nations Security Council permanent membership are all nations that have their own indigenous languages. Just an observation. For example, France speaks French, China Mandarin, Chinese, Russia speaks Russian, Britain speaks English, which is their language, and US speaks English, which is the English language, the US language. Because 104 Britons founded the colony we currently know today as US on the 13th of March 1607 in Jamestown, Virginia, when they first landed. And that later became what you know as the 13 colonies of America and today the United States of America. And they speak English. But most African nations speak foreign languages. For example, I myself am speaking English, which is not an African language. You go across Africa, the official languages are all foreign languages. So these are probably the criteria, one of the criteria that they checked and refused to admit any African nation to the United Nations Security Council permanent membership. And also, it's a deliberate choice to give permanent membership to themselves, the veto power to themselves, to make sure that they continue to dominate nations in the world. And they know that if Africa should have the permanent membership seat, that Africa can begin to veto some of the resolutions against Africa, and that Africa will become sort of a world power. And because of that, they will refuse to give it to Africa, and they have refused so far. Now, what should we do about this? How do we get the permanent security seat, and what should we do about it? And first of all, has there been some attempts by Africans to do anything about this? Yes, In the year 2010, South Africa demanded that Africa should have two permanent seats, one for South Africa and one for any other African nation. And in the year 2012, the foreign ministers of two African nations, Mauritania and Algeria, demanded that Africa should have a permanent seat and also one for Arab nations. And during the reforms discussions in the General Assembly that was held in the year 2020, that of last year, there were speeches by African leaders that Africa should have two permanent seats and five non-permanent seats in the United Nations Security Council. And so far, we have not yet made any much headway into having a permanent seat in the United Nations Security Council. We must take this seriously. And first of all, we must understand that it is a very Herculean task to get an African permanent membership seat in the Security Council. This is because one of the most difficult tasks in the world is to amend the United Nations Charter. Because to amend this charter and allow a reformation in the Security Council will require 2/3 of the votes of all the 103 members of the United Nations General Assembly. And all the 5 permanent members of the United Nations Security Council must vote yes in order to reform the United Nations Security Council, which you know is very difficult to achieve. Therefore, there are steps Africa must follow in order to have a reform in the United Nations Security Council. And number one, Africa must first of all choose what exactly we want. One, do we want permanent seats in the United Nations Security Council, or do we want all nations of the world to be part of the membership of the United Nations Security Council? We must first of all choose what we want, and I'll come to that. Number two, Africa must choose nations that will represent Africa in the Security Council permanent membership. Is it Nigeria and South Africa, as some people have been proposing, which are the two largest economies in Africa and among the most populous in Africa? I think no. But China is an Asian nation, but China has not been representing India in the Security Council. US has not been representing Mexico or representing Southern American nations, even though it's in America. So Nigeria might not be able to represent the interests of other African nations, and also South Africa might not represent the interests of SADC nations or other nations of Africa. Instead, Africa must represent herself generally in the Security Council if we're to get a seat. And that should be through the African ambassador to the United Nations, who should go and represent all Africans in the United Nations Security Permanent Seats. Whereas the 5 non-permanent seats should go to East, West, North, South and Central Africa. Number 3, Africa should have a full-fledged parliament. The Malabo Protocol of the year 2014 should be ratified. African nations should ratify the Malabo Protocol that needs 28 members of the African Union to ratify to give Africa a full-fledged parliament. So far, only 12 African nations have signed that protocol. In order that Africa should have a full-fledged parliament, so that through the African Parliament, we can pass a resolution demanding permanent seats and 5 non-permanent seats in the United Nations Security Council, or a general reformation of the United Nations Security Council, and also reforming the relationship between the Security Council and the General Assembly, or what not. Then, fourthly, Africa must work with other nations of the world. Germany, India, Brazil, non-aligned movement, the Global South. These nations and groups want reform in the United Nations Security Council. Some of them want permanent seats, some of them want all nations of the world to be part of the United Nations Security Council and no veto given to any nation. They want to have a full-fledged democratic United Nations. So Africa must work with them. In order to have the 2/3 votes needed to reform the United Nations, Africa must work with the non-aligned movement, the Global South, and all these other nations that are agitating for a reformation in the United Nations Security Council. And when these nations come together, we can now get the 2/3 votes in the General Assembly and then pressurize the 5 permanent members of the United Nations Security Council to accept a reformation of the United Nations. And if they refuse to accept, we must use all diplomatic measures to pressurize them, even the threat of boycotting the United Nations, in order to make them to sign that reformation and have a truly democratic United Nations. Then, lastly or finally, what should we demand? Is it 2 permanent seats and 5 non-permanent seats, or an inclusive United Nations? The best we can demand is an inclusive United Nations. African nations should not just go about seek for a permanent seat in the Security Council, or 2 permanent seats and 5 non-permanent seats. Instead, let us demand that the United Nations Security Council, just like the General Assembly, should include all the nations of the United Nations. All the 193 members of the United Nations should be part and parcel of the United Nations Security Council. There is nothing wrong about that, and it will not spoil anything. What spoiled the League of Nations was that nations that were part of the League Council all had veto powers, and because of that, they could not agree on anything. But there should be no veto power in the Security Council. All nations of the United Nations Security Council should have permanent seats, but none should have any veto. That is what we should demand for. But as a second option, Africa should then demand a permanent seat. So the African Parliament should seek a reformation of Article 27, verse 1 of the United Nations Security Council, that states that every Security Council member should have a single vote. Instead, Africa should then get 2 votes given to the United Nations Security Council permanent member from Africa. So instead of having 2, South Africa and Nigeria, Africa would then have only the African ambassador, but carrying 2 votes. And then East Africa, West Africa, North Africa, South Africa, and Central Africa are having non-permanent seats in the United Nations Security Council. That would give Africa totally 7 votes in the United Nations Security Council. But that is only for the second option, as I said earlier. The best is to have an inclusive United Nations, where all 55 member states of the African Union are all permanent members of the United Nations Security Council, and no nation in the world should have a veto vote in the United Nations. That is what Africa should demand for, and these are the steps we should follow. If we go about this in the right way, or the way we have already outlined, and pressurize the United Nations, we'll get it. And then we can use that seat to address all the many problems that Africa has suffered through the hands of the colonizers of Africa, get the reparations, get everything we need to get. By then, we have already gotten a truly democratic United Nations. Don't forget to subscribe. Let's grow the channel and let's pass the message across. One Africa, Africa must rise again, from last to first, from the poorest continent to the richest continent in the world, from the least powerful continent in the world to the most powerful continent in the world. Ubuntu, Uhuru.